are now starting with the second chapter in this unit of diversity in living world, and that is biological classification. Now, when we talk of biological classification, we need to have some historical background that how this classification system actually evolved and which is the one which we are using right now. So this earliest classification which was put forth was by Aristotle. And Aristotle classified all the living organisms into two categories. So this is basically a two kingdom classification which was given. So we can say this is a two kingdom classification, and this is one of the earliest ones which was put forth. And he classified all the organisms into only two categories, that is plants and animals. And in plants, all unicellular, multicellular, every type of plant was placed. And these plants were further classified on the basis of their sizes. So tall ones were called the trees, then the smaller than that were the shrubs, and the very small delicate plants were called the herbs. So this was just on the basis of morphological structure. And here it was those who could synthesize their own food, that is autotrophs and heterotrophs. Animals were further classified into only two categories, the ones with red blood and the others without it. So it was just a very, very basic classification which was given. Then came another two kingdom classification, which was by Linnaeus. And Linnaeus gets the credit of giving the actual two kingdom classification. So this classification, which was given by Linnaeus, was also a two kingdom classification. And Linnaeus, apart from the morphological structures, also used some more characters. But the categories in which those organisms were classified were two. So plants and animals, but further classification, not only morphological, but some other characters were also used. Now these two classifications, which are two kingdom classifications, could not explain many, many important things. Like, where should we place Euglena kind of organisms? Euglena has some characters like plants, that means it can perform photosynthesis like character because it has chloroplast. So this is a plant like character, but it is without cell wall. So absence of cell wall is an animal character. And they were also not able to place the fungi kind of organisms. Where are these saprophytes? Saprophytes, they don't eat anything. They take the nourishment from the decomposing organic matter. So there were many, many things which are missing, but these were the initial classifications. So these were taken for a very, very long period of time. Then came the three kingdom classification, and it was given by Ernst Haeckel. And this classification was a three kingdom classification. That means he added one more kingdom, and these three kingdoms were the newly added Protista, then the autotrophic, that was Plantae, and then Animalia. And in Protista, he placed unicellular organisms. Now, when we say unicellular organisms, all unicellular organisms were placed here. But again, there was no specific place for fungi type of organisms. So this was the one which was given by Ernst Haeckel. This was a three kingdom classification. Then Copeland, he gave a four kingdom classification. So here new kingdom was added. That is the fourth one. So it was four kingdom classification. Now the kingdoms were newly added Monera, and the three were same, that is Protista, then Plantae, And the last one is Animalia. So this is for the first time when prokaryotes and eukaryotes were separated. So Monera included prokaryotes and Protista included unicellular eukaryotes. So it was like even better classification. Then came the five kingdom classification, which was given by Whittaker. And the classification one which we are using these days most commonly, it is five kingdom classification. And in this five kingdom, now for the first time fungi or kingdom fungi was added. So according to this, the kingdoms were Monera, then Protista, then fungi, and the two were the first two which were given, that is Plantae and Animalia. Now Monera included unicellular prokaryotes, or we can simply write prokaryotes. Protista included unicellular eukaryotes. Fungi included the saprophytes, and Plantae included autotrophs, and the Animalia, that was the heterotrophs. So this is the classification which we are using these days. We will be talking about the criteria which were taken to study this classification in the next video. Then a six kingdom classification was given, and that was given by Woos. So Woos gave one more kingdom. So now we have a six kingdom classification. Though there is a six kingdom classification, but we still are following the five one, because Monera has already been divided into two subcategories, that is Archaebacteria and Eubacteria. So we anyway are studying it here. But in case of Woos's classification, which is six kingdom classification, Monera has been divided into two. So we have Archaebacteria. Archaebacteria, this is one. Then Eubacteria, this is second kingdom. Then same, Protista. Then fungi and Plantae and Animalia. So this is how we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And these two actually are coming from the Monera part. So, as I said, we are using Whittaker's classification because in Kingdom Monera there are two subcategories, Archaebacteria and Eubacteria. So it is easier to study, but there are six kingdoms which have been given. Archaebacteria, this one includes old, ancient bacteria which could survive, or which can still survive in all adverse conditions. That means they can be found in extremely cold regions as well as in hot water or springs where the temperature can go as high as 100 degrees. That means they can be found in boiling water also. Eubacteria, these are advanced bacteria. So the present day bacteria, which are slightly evolved bacteria. So these are like old ancient ones, and these are advanced bacteria. Protista is same, unicellular organisms. Protista is further divided into groups like photosynthetic protist, then protozoan protist and all. Fungi is the group of saprophytes, Plantae of autotrophs, and Animalia of heterotrophs. So this is how the classification actually took place. Beginning was done with basic classification, which was two kingdoms, and it had many drawbacks. But because this was like the first attempt to classify all living organisms, we appreciate this classification. And the one which we are following in present time is Whittaker's five kingdom classification. In the next part, we'll talk about all those details, all those characteristic features which were taken into account when this classification was given. Because when only one or few categories are used, one or few characters are used, then the classification becomes an artificial classification. Natural system, it is going to include all different types of classifications. So we can say that these classifications, maybe this one, this one, this one, and this one, which used some very superficial categories. So we can call especially these three as artificial system of classification. What does it mean? Artificial system means when few characters are taken into account, and when many characters, or we can say all the characters are taken into account, then we call it natural system. So we can say Whitaker's or Boose's classification or Copeland's classification, these are under natural system of classification. So what does it mean? Well, all characters are included or studied except evolution. So there are two main categories, artificial system or natural system. Now in the next part, we'll take up Whitaker's classification in detail.